I'm Craig Johnson. Today is the day that many wrestling fans have been waiting for. The North American Championship. The first matchup face-to-face between the Patriot and the Dark Patriot. Right now, I want to bring in the man in the red, white, and blue. And the first question I have, has the belt been found yet?
No, the belt hasn't been found yet. But you've got one thing right. Today is the day. Tonight is the night that I've been waiting for. It's the night that these people right here have been waiting for. Because we've had to put up long enough with the imposter. We've had to put up long enough with this guy coming out here to my music. He's got my name. He's got my belt. And he said he wants to take my soul and he wants to take my mask. Well, I'm going to tell you what, I've got a dark side too, just as everyone else out here has. When you're pushed too far, when you're backed into a corner, then that dark side comes out. And you know what? I like it. I like the feeling. I like the feeling of that dark side, because that's what it's going to take tonight for me to come out on top. So he started something here. He's created something here that's gotten out of control, and he's not going to be able to handle it. Because when these people get to stomping their feet and clapping their hands, and they get behind me, and they get to chanting Patriot, well, then that's just too much for anybody to overcome, Craig. Do you know what I mean? You know what I'm talking about?
The Patriot, one-on-one, eye-to-eye, how right. is the I don't think he wants to talk about it. He's ready for the Dark Patriot. We'll have that, our main event today on Supercard. Stay tuned.
Get ready, basketball fans. It's coming right at you. Showtime! Your chance to get every magic moment all on one incredible video. Magic Johnson, always Showtime. It's free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated, the nation's number one sports weekly. Your free video is a dazzling look at the fabulous career of Urban Magic Johnson. He digs down deep into his bag of tricks to take you on a victory ride you won't forget.
Straight down the middle. Still going, still going.
Oh! You'll cheer every exciting minute as you follow this leader up and down the court, wherever he goes, from high school to college to the pros. He just keeps on winning with an enthusiasm, a spirit, and style that would change the NBA. Call this toll-free number now to be sure you get in on all the excitement free.
2 seconds, Magic's 18-footer wins it!
Don't miss the rookie's first NBA championship as he rises above the crowd to stun the Sixers. And you'll be there for all the battles with the legendary Larry Bird, the rivalry that started in college and continued in the NBA. You'll feel the intensity, the frustration, and the excitement as the two fight for the last shot, the one that makes champions.
Didn't shoot in 5 seconds left. Backing down middle, just what I thought. A hook shot at 12. Yeah!
Magic's just a great basketball player. He's the best I've ever seen.
Get 60 minutes of memorable magic, free from Sports Illustrated. Get your free video and 54 issues of Sports Illustrated, including the Olympic preview and the famous swimsuit issue, for only $1.29 an issue. Save over 55% off the cover price. You may use your credit card. Follow all your favorites in Sports Illustrated. Call now to subscribe or renew and get this memorable video free. For quicker delivery, use your credit card. The magic of Urban Johnson will always be something special, something we can't forget. Treasure it always. And every week, enjoy the continuing drama and emotion of sports in Sports Illustrated.
Well, there you see the poster. $10,000 on the head of Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. The television champion joins me here on Supercard. It was 7 days ago when Akbar's men tried to collect that bounty. And it's hard to tell who your friends are, who your enemies are, and I have never seen you so serious.
Well, Craig, you know, first off, in professional wrestling, you really have no friends. It doesn't matter where you're at, whether you're in the promotion of the wrestling, or whether you're a wrestler, whether you're a referee, whether you're a manager, whether you're even an announcer, you never can tell if you have friends or no friends. So I just want the warning to go out now. Boys, you can play games with everybody else. You can put money on people's heads, whoever it is that's doing it. You got the Patriot, you got his eye. Well, Akbar, Falcone, and Bart, you've started something now. Let's see, boys, if you can finish it, because I don't think anybody can.
Well, Barry Horowitz with $1,000 of Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert's money. And the rules basically are, if Barry Horowitz does not defeat...
Ladies and gentlemen, repeating,
Well, Ron Ames will tell you here.
Barry Horowitz must win the match, or Ben Jordan will get $1,000.
And that's it in black and white. The winner against Ben Jordan. Our opening contest today on Supercard. Fans anticipating the first matchup between the Patriot and the Dark Patriot. It is still to come. This our opening bout, one fall. And that fall better belong to Barry Horowitz, otherwise Eddie Gilbert will be out yet another $1,000. Ben Jordan clamping on the armbar. Jordan ranked in the top contenders in the light heavyweight division of the Global Wrestling Federation. Just recently, Barry Horowitz took on Jerry Lynn for the light heavyweight championship and was very close to winning it, but Jerry Lynn able to get the 1-2-3 as the winner notches another loss. Elbow in to the face. Headbutt. And for a man known as the winner, the records really don't verify the situation. Barry Horowitz won a match over Terry Daniels. We saw that match quite a few times here in the GWF. More times than we would have liked to have seen a simple match by Barry Horowitz. But then the videotape came out. $49.95 for 6 minutes of great action. He claimed it was a bargain. Then Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert proclaimed Barry Horowitz a member of the First Family, presented him with his own championship belt, the winner's belt. And if you take a close look at the winner's belt, the strangest looking belt you'd ever see, with a faceplate on it that looks more like something off a tuna can than on a championship belt. And Horowitz taking his time. He better watch out, because if he's counted out, Eddie Gilbert loses $1,000, and I think he's just realizing that. Ben Jordan breaking the count, talking to John Keaton, allowing Barry Horowitz a little bit more time than... Well, left him just enough time to think about what he was going to do next. And now over to the corner post. Horowitz sending Jordan's leg in to the post. We're going to take a break. We'll be back with more of this matchup. Remember, still to come on this edition, the Patriot against the Dark Patriot. Chaz against Mike Davis. Still a lot more action to go. Still a lot more action. Here is Sam Houston has come down to ringside. Well, we'll keep it right here at the Global Dome as Sam Houston has come down to ringside, getting the fans behind Ben Jordan. We're going to take a break. We'll be back with more. Don't go away.
It's time for Saving the Green on 100 used cars and trucks at Pat McEwen Ford in Dodge City. The finest factory official program and one-owner cars you'll find anywhere. All our cars and trucks pass a 51-point safety check by certified mechanics. Receive a guaranteed $1,000 for your trade-in, and for the luck of the Irish, green cars are an extra $250. Here at Pat McEwen's, we're making other car dealers green with envy with our low, low prices at Pat McEwen Ford in Dodge City, U.S. 31 South, Charlevoix.
Open your eyes to great entertainment in March with HBO and Cinemax. See why HBO is simply the best with great movies.
I made my family disappear.
Jammin' comedy, exciting originals, and sexy specials. Look at Cinemax. If you like movies,
no problem.
Lots of movies. More than 170 in March. For eye-opening entertainment, call now and get HBO and Cinemax.
Lose head first. Woo!
World Cup Skeleton, Friday night at 8 Eastern on ESPN. They call him the Troy Tiger from New York. Kevin Pompey is ready to get his claws into Stephon Johnson for the coveted USBA Championship. Top Rank Boxing, Friday night, live on ESPN.
We come back to the action. High backdrop. As now Chaz has even made his way to ringside to help cheer on the light heavyweight. $1,000 of Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert's money is on the line. And a kick sends down Ben Jordan. Takes him over to the rope. Horowitz right in front of Sam Houston. Comes down on the side of the leg. Horowitz has to beat Ben Jordan. And the leg whip takes Jordan down. If Horowitz does not beat Ben Jordan, $1,000 of Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert's money goes to the youngster from Phoenix, Arizona. Chaz and Sam Houston leading the cheers, but it may not be enough, a count of two. Knee into the thigh area. And the fans starting to chant Wiener. Pressure being put on the leg. Ben Jordan trying to keep his shoulders off the mat. Count of one there. Count of two until Jordan kicks up. Enough to take Barry Horowitz away. One more time, the sole of the boot right into the face. And Ben Jordan may be working on a bad leg. But Barry Horowitz has not been able to do what he needs to do, and that is pin him. Bow and arrow, a very painful maneuver by the winner. And Horowitz almost pinned there. Watch out from behind. One, two, almost the count of two. Chaz and Sam Houston continue to lead the cheers. Ben Jordan in our opening matchup once again takes punishment on that leg. And now Jerry Lynn has come to ringside. The light heavyweight champion of the GWF cheering for Ben Jordan. Gary Young is even down there. Put away Ben Jordan. Once again, the leg whip. A devastating maneuver. Straight by the leg. Count of two, but Jordan still escapes. Rolls over. Count of one. Has him locked in for two, but once again, Jordan able to get out. Side of the head. Jordan delivers a couple of shots. reversal by Horowitz. Reversal by Jordan. Four consecutive two counts there. Horowitz going for the backslide. One, two, almost a count of three. Time running out here in this matchup. You can hear the countdown. The time limit has expired. And John Keaton approaching Ben Jordan gives him the check. Horowitz did not defeat Ben Jordan. $1,000 goes to Ben Jordan. And he's being carried out of the Global Dome. We're going to be back with more on the GWF right after this. Stay tuned on ESPN. How about that?
Giving our fans a chance to ask some questions here in Major League Wrestling. I'm Bonnie Blackstone in the Global Dome. This is Raymond and this is Brad, a great brother team here. You guys come to all the great matches. You had a question for Wild Bill Irwin that I'm going to be asking him a little bit later on. What is your question for Wild Bill?
Why did Black Bart turn on you?
It hit you with the horseshoe.
And hit you with the horseshoe. Later on, I'm going to be asking Wild Bill Irwin these questions that Brad and Raymond want to have answered. Why did your former partner turn on you and betray you as he did?
Call us right now for your free Alabama Book of Surprises.
Alabama.
You'll find one surprise after another. Enough surprises to fill a vacation. Enough memories to last a lifetime.
In Alabama.
Alabama. Special moments you'll want to keep forever.
General Nutrition Center's Pro Performance Amino 1000, the scientifically developed protein supplement. Amino 1000 can help give you the edge. The Amino 1000 gel capsule, designed for fast absorption. Amino 1000, exclusively at GNC, the authority in sports nutrition.
The time has come for Commissioner Max Andrews to do something about the bounty situation. Hello, everyone. I'm Joe Pedicino here in the newsroom behind stages at the Global Dome. And we'll be going back out for some more great action in just a couple of minutes. But right now, I want to talk about this bounty situation. And I'll tell you right now, they might as well put editorial right across the front of this because that's what this is going to be. It's going to be my opinion on what is going on in the Global Wrestling Federation and this bounty situation. Who is it that is putting out the bounties? So far, there's been a $10,000 bounty put on the head of the Patriot. Already, Scott Anthony, the Dark Patriot, and many others have gone after that bounty. And so far, the Patriot, in my opinion, has been lucky to get out with just one eye wounded. Now we find out there is a $10,000 bounty also on the head of the very man who I suspected of putting the bounty on the Patriot. That is Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. That's right. In the past few days, there have been wanted posters put out through all of the Global Wrestling Federation dressing rooms offering a $10,000 reward to anyone who ends the career or causes the retirement of Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. Now, that's the Patriot and Eddie Gilbert, two men on completely opposite sides. We've got to wonder who is putting out these bounties. I'm calling for Max Andrews to step in and put an end to this situation. There is no place in professional wrestling, in my opinion, for bounties. If you're going to get in the ring and beat a man, if you're going to take his title, if you're going to beat him and take a mask, that's one thing. But if you are going to sit back like a weasel in the background and put a $10,000 bounty on the head of a man, you have no place in what I call the sport of professional wrestling. And yes, that is my opinion. That's the newsroom for today. We'll be back with more on the GWF.
Earlier on this edition, Raymond was with me. Right now, Bill Irwin has joined me to answer Raymond's question. He wants to know why your former partner, Black Bart, turned his back on you.
Well, I don't know. Let me just put it out to you, Black Bart. Why did you turn on me? Was it for money? Did Akbar come down and maybe line your pockets? Or was it maybe that you just couldn't stand to be in the ring with me and all the fans, all the good people cheering behind us? I don't know. Sometimes you're a little crazy. You get off in a weird situation. But, Bart, I know one thing, that when all these people applaud and they're all behind me, I get goosebumps. I just love it. And I know sometimes Bart was going, well, what are those people doing? What's wrong with them? Well, hey, Bart, they like you. They like me. They like a lot of people around here. But, Bart, I know some people just don't have it in them to be friendly. Some of us are just from the beginning, and you are one of them. And you're one big that I'm just going to have to clean up.
This ESPN program is brought to you by Smooth Busch Beer, an easy-drinking Busch Light.
What makes a mountain man a mountain man? Let's find out. Must a mountain man be a big, burly guy with an axe? Do you have steel? Must a mountain man even be a man?
About this Patriot versus Dark Patriot matchup, I saw the Patriots' intensity, and I have never seen a man so set on one thing as the Patriot is with his matchup against the Dark Patriot this week here.
After the situation where the Dark Patriot put that ink into a man's eyes and has blinded him, we don't know if the Patriot's going to be able to see again. Plus, then the situation with the Patriot's belt disappearing, it's just... Well, it's out of control.
Yeah, you just can't blame the Patriot, I guess, for being a little upset, huh?
Not at all. Into the ropes. Chaz fakes the cross body block. Mr. Davis, don't look now. Nice move there by Chaz, getting the upper hand. Laying in the right.
Well, if Chaz wants to trade punches with somebody, he's trading with the wrong guy in Mike Davis. But there again, Chaz going for every opportunity to go for the pin. Mike Davis looking for a timeout. But gosh, Gregor, there are timeouts in professional wrestling.
Not that I know of or have heard of.
And you are the veteran announcer.
If you'd like to say that, I'll take the compliment. Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Side headlock by Chaz. As I mentioned, former light heavyweight champion of the Global Wrestling Federation defeated the Lightning Kid for that title. The Lightning Kid able to regain the belt a little later, but Chaz always on the heels going after the championship belt. Cross body catches Mike Davis. Trying to deliver the head scissors, gets the legs over and pulls them down. And now into the rear chin lock.
Now see, Chaz, he should stick to the high flying. Chaz should stick to going to the air. Speed and agility. He's trying power moves on Mike Davis right now, and that's not the way to beat Mike Davis. You don't wear a guy like Mike Davis down.
Mike Davis, who has been in the ring wars for so long, has faced adversity before. But recently, he's had the help of his brother, Tom. And I don't know if he's been using that as a crutch or not.
Well, with or without his brother, Tom, Mike Davis is dangerous in that ring.
Well, he's got the advantage here, the knee into the throat. Breaks it before the count of five, and Chaz, roundhouse right that he kept on spinning around to the midsection, two times. Into the corner, full velocity. Chaz. For the opportunity, Mike Davis. Hey, he's got something in the hands. Delivers the right and the feet on the right. Count of three.
The veteran won.
Mike Davis did indeed win. When we return, we'll hear words from Terry Garvin. Plus, the main event, the Patriots.
Hey, we can-
bring the Patriot out here, right?
Sure.
I got something I'd like to present to him.
We'll do that in just
please,
a minute.
If you could, Greg. Yeah.
Dear Dad,
before he became a legend,
I've joined the Mexican Revolution.
He was young Indy.
Sorry about high school.
Riding with Pancho Villa and running guns in the Congo. For him, just growing up was the greatest adventure of all. He lives a life others only dream of. Now, premiering this week on ABC Television.
Definitely gonna miss high school.
George Lucas presents the Young Indiana Jones Chronicles. At GMC Truck, our only business is trucks, and has been for over 80 years. A dedication to truck strengths and values to keep in mind. Because when you need to haul something, tow something, carry precious cargo, find new trails, or simply ride high and proud, there's nothing quite as strong as a truck. GMC Truck, the strength of experience.
Sometimes you feel like a nut. Sometimes you don't. Almond joy got nuts. Mounds don't. Because sometimes you feel like a... Sometimes...
If you were with us last Monday here on ESPN, you saw a very strange situation involving Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and the man standing to my right, Terry Garvin. I don't know even how to start to explain it.
Well, I'll tell you, Eddie Gilbert and I have sure had our differences, as you know. There's been chains involved. There's been fire thrown on my body and my face. And Eddie, I really don't like you as a human being, but as a wrestler, I do have respect for you. I tried to convey that message, you know, Monday, to you right in the middle of the ring like two men would. I tried to shake your hand, and it just didn't seem to happen. But I do have respect for you, Eddie Gilbert. Again, I don't like you, and I hope sometime in the very, very near future I get another shot at that belt, because I know I can win it, and I know I deserve a chance.
At 252 pounds, from the dark side of America, the Dark Patriot!
Well, there you see the Dark Patriot making his way down to ringside. I'm joined by Bruce Pritchard for this big event here in the Global Wrestling Federation. This is the one we've been waiting for.
This is what everybody's been waiting for.
The North American title. And there you see the very devious man. And Bruce Pritchard, you had asked to talk to the man in the red, white, and blue. The Patriot is here. I know he's got the Dark Patriot on his
Patriot.
Mind right now.
Patriot, first of all, I'd like to say it is a pleasure to see you back. And my friend, I have something for you that I know you've been looking for a while.
He was talking about this earlier.
That's my belt.
It's
my friend, your North American belt. I know you've been looking at that. I found it. I wanted you to have it. And I know that you have other things on your mind right now. So if you want, I'll hold this belt so everybody knows where it is. And I'll make sure that you get it later. But I know you have more important things on your mind. So I just wanted you to know it was safe and sound, my friend.
And the Patriot making a quick exit here, going down to ringside. We're ready for action. As the Patriot in there with the Dark Patriot. No time for introductions. We are ready for the main event, and over the top he goes.
Well, the Patriot is fired up. There's no doubt about it. This is the first time, Craig, that the Patriot's had his opportunity to get his hands on the Dark Patriot since that blinding, and he's not going to let anybody stop him.
The Patriot laying in the laps, into the ropes. High back drop. And the Dark Patriot looking for shelter. And the Dark Patriot may be leaving the arena.
Well, not if the Patriot has anything to say about it, because they're right up here by us, Craig. They're not going to stop.
They go in the dark regions of the Global Dome.
Patriot, as we said earlier, he wants this guy. And he's not going to let the Dark Patriot get away that easy. Not at all.
Into the post. The Dark Patriot looking for cover somewhere else.
Well, he's not going to find it at the top of the global, though, because if he looks right behind
him, they're into the seats.
He's got the Patriot following him all over.
They're into the seats, into the fans here at the global.
Great Lakes Oldsmobile dealers are proud to introduce the best value we've ever offered. The all-new 1992 Achieva. It's available right now for just $199 a month. $199 for 48 months with no money down. And the new Achieva comes packed with features. Air conditioning, automatic transmission, AM/FM stereo cassette, aluminum wheels, and more for just $199 a month. See your Great Lakes Olds dealer today. Tallburg, Chevy Olds, Bayview Road, Petoskey.
Planning to build or remodel this spring? Make plans to attend Preston Feather's House and Home Celebration this weekend at North Central Michigan College. See what's new for your home, including beautiful Permador entrance doors. Attend do-it-yourself workshops featuring L.J. Smith stair systems and Marvin window tilt pack replacements. For more information, visit either of Preston Feather's two locations. See you this weekend at the House and Home Celebration.
Preston Feather.
Michigan's explosive Fab Five take it to the hole against Jim Jackson and Ohio State. Then it's LSU's Shaq against Arkansas's May Day attack. As big as it gets, Big Tuesday, live on ESPN.
The Dark Patriot rolling into the ring, the Patriot following him. The action finally in the ring.
Well, the Patriot up on that second rope. I don't think the referee's gonna be able to stop him with a warning like that.
Shots to the head. And the Patriot approaching the man that took half his sight away.
And this is what we have all waited for, Greg. The confrontation between the Dark Patriot and the man of the red, white, and blue. The Patriot.
The Dark Patriot going after the eye once again. That eye probably still burning under the eye patch. I know it has been a few weeks since that injury, but it was enough. He's taking the eye patch totally off now.
That may be the first time the Patriot's eye has seen light in a while.
The Dark Patriot trying to get the suplex in the ring of the red, white, and blue. Using Patriot power to get him up and over. But both men on the mat now. And the Patriot and the Dark Patriot on their knees. Each man getting in.
And the Dark Patriot raking the eye that time.
Now going after Patriot. Both of them. And now the Dark Patriot having words with James Beard. the Dark Patriot. Looked like he may be rolling to the outside to take a timeout of his own. And now, even the Patriot has gotten very upset. Going after the man who tried to take his side away. Now going after the mask.
Well, not only the man that's trying to take his side away, but also the man trying to take his mask and his soul.
What a good match.
Yeah.
Let me ask you about the belt. Where did you find it?
You know, Craig, first of all, I'm a little sick and tired of your stooging, nosy comments.
What?
I'm sick of listening to your you pig, because
what are you
every time
about?
That you come out here and you talk about this, you're full of you're nothing but a bunch of
talking
and
about.
I'm kind of tired of it, my friend. Yeah, my friend.
What has gotten into you?
Talk.
What has you gotten into you?
Do you have a clue?
Huh? What has
do you? Why don't you look
brain?
In the mirror sometimes?
What has gotten into your brain?
The Ultimate Wrestling Hotline, the Global Wrestling Hotline, with latest news from all organizations, exclusive interviews with your favorite stars, win a Super Nintendo and games by playing wrestling trivia. The GWF Hotline, $1.99 for the first minute and then 99 cents for each additional minute. Kids, make sure your parents know before you call. Call the GWF Wrestling Hotline.
This is me, Vicky. Before I went on a diet and started using an Easy Glider, I lost 125 pounds. Here I am, 2 years later, still using my Easy Glider, and I haven't gained any of the weight back.
Easy Glider's not just for exercise anymore. This 20-minute workout gets you on your way to total fitness with cardiovascular conditioning, muscle toning, and yes, weight loss.
I watched what I ate, I drank a lot of water, I used my Easy Glider, and that's how I lost 59 pounds.
It's low impact and works both your upper and lower body. You can burn up to 300 calories per workout.
I tried jogging, playing racquetball, and even starving myself, but nothing lasted or made me feel as good as my Easy Glider.
And it folds flat for easy storage.
You get a lot of exercise for your money with an Easy Glider.
Call toll-free 1-800-632-1700. We'll bill your credit card. Three easy payments of $19.95 each. You get a full 60-day home trial with money-back guarantee. The total price, $59.85 plus $9 shipping and handling. So call 1-800-632-1700 now.
I do not know what has gotten into Bruce Prichard. He's made his way down to ringside. He said that he found the championship belt. And a clothesline delivered by the Dark Patriot. Half Nelson and a cover, count of one, count of two, but the Patriot powers out. I don't understand what is going on. My broadcast partner, Bruce Prichard, came up, and when I asked him about the belt, he went totally nuts. I just asked him where he found it. The Dark Patriot putting the boot into the throat. Once again, these men have battled all the way around the Global Dome. Into the ropes, high backdrop, and just sitting on the stage. Count of one and count of two, count of almost three. Just sitting on the stage, holding the belt. I have no idea what he's doing down there, just looking at the belt. He says that he found the belt and was happy to present it back to the Patriot. The Dark Patriot punishing the man in the red, white, and blue.
North American champ.
Once again, using the ropes for extra leverage.
My.
And there you see Bruce admiring the belt. In the ring, the Dark Patriot has had the advantage for almost 5 minutes now. The man in the red, white, and blue is tired. The Dark Patriot has raked both of his eyes. He has stripped the eye patch off, and I think the Patriot has had about enough. The man in the red, white, and blue delivering the fist. Into the ropes, but the boot up by the Dark Patriot. Clothesline sends the real Patriot down. There's a cover, count of one, count of two. And the Patriot able to get the shoulder up. Once again, a count of two.
Shut up!
What is going through the mind of my former broadcast partner? What is going through the mind of the Dark Patriot? Well, right now, a little pain as the Patriot out of the way, getting out of the way of the elbow. The man in the red, white, and blue, up to both feet now. The fans cheering USA, but will it be enough? The Dark Patriot working on the eye and now delivers the right. Another right. Yet another right. But I think that the Patriot is firing up the rocket. Firing up. Into the ropes. The Patriot delivering the left into the rope. Drop kick. Dark Patriot trying to get out of the way. Cover. Count of two. Picks him up with a slam and takes him down. The Patriot going up. Up to the top rope. Looking to deliver the missile. And he misses. The Dark Patriot out of the way. The referee down. Reversal by the Patriot. High backdrop. Down goes the Dark Patriot. Official James Beard trying to shake out the cobwebs. The Patriot with a whip into the corner. Follows him in. Misses with the shoulder. The Dark Patriot. Now he will go to the outside. To the higher elevation to try to deliver his version of the missile. James Beard pushes the Patriot out of the way, and James Beard has been hit by the Dark Patriot. The Patriot delivers the clothesline. He's ready to try to put away the Dark Patriot. He goes up to the top, and the Patriot missile delivered on the Dark Patriot. Bruce Pritchard is getting into the ring. He's got the belt in his hand, and he hits him on the back of the head. What is Bruce Pritchard doing? Bruce Pritchard has hit the Patriot, and he's taking James Beard over there. One, two, no!
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match and new GWF North American champion, the Dark Patriot.
I just can't believe how it happened. We'll be back.
Diamond Queen. Dealer gets a 10.
The kid's got him.
No, he's got the jack.
You're good, kid. These cards.
An old deck of cards can ruin your whole night. So get a new deck of bicycle cards, because your reputation is on the table.
You really blew it, kid.
Saddle up, partner, for a Sunday night shootout. There'll be a showdown when the ladies of the LPBT roll into town for the Yuma Open, Sunday night at the Sports Center on ESPN.
Folks right here, and then some kind of like this happens.
I don't know what the hell got into Bruce Pritchard.
I thought he was an honest, trustworthy man. He comes out here and tells me he's gonna keep that belt, my prized possession, what I fought so hard for, and these Patriots fought so hard for. And I'll be if I'm gonna let it happen. I promise you one thing. Somebody's gonna pay. Somebody's gonna pay. You're right, I got a dark side. And when I track them down, Greg, I'm gonna kick their ever loving.
Here at the Global Dome, this picture speaks for itself. Block one time, step over, Putski. Don't look now, elbow drop. And Dane is going to take a rest break. Putski has done a lot of waiting on Stephen Dane, and I think he's tired of it. Stephen Dane, whenever he can get a rest break, we'll take one. And he's taking one here. Scott Putski against Stephen Dane. They've been going at it for a while here, but now Stephen Dane wants to extend a hand of friendship. Some people would say it's a hand of fiendship. Dane and Scott Putski in action here in the Global Wrestling Federation, as these two men are trying to decide whether or not they trust the other. Putski holds out the hand for a handshake. And Stephen Dane, who originally, oh, there's a handshake, but oh my! The Polish power of Scott Putski. Maybe a mistake by Stephen Dane. He wants to, no! You're not going to get out of that vice grip that easily. Ouch! That hurts just watching it. Stephen Dane over the top rope. Back in he comes. Scott Putski extends the hand of friendship and then squeezes it a little hard there. Stephen Dane out to the outside. I wonder if there's any circulation left in that hand. Putski from the famous wrestling family showing Stephen Dane a thing or two. His father, Ivan Putski, a star in the WWF for many years, back even when it was the WWWF. That's a long time ago. Well, let's see if Stephen Dane's anxious to shake hands with Scott Putski now. Putski having fun with the sensational one. The lockup. And now Dane trying to get leverage. But in a power for power struggle, I think I'd have to give the advantage to Putski. The intangible there, actually, object, the hair of Scott Putski, used by Stephen Dane to gain the advantage. Once again, Putski will try to power out. The muscles in the arms absolutely flexing, but once again, Stephen Dane using the shortcut. One more time. Let's see if the third time is indeed the charm, as the old saying goes. As a pull of the hair, and look who got caught. Stephen Dane breaks the hold momentarily, and then I believe put a thumb right into the eye. Double axe handle to the back. And now a knee right to the jaw. Stephen Dane wants to make sure that Scott Putski will not get the Duke on this occasion. Putski delivers right to the body, but it was returned by Stephen Dane. Kick to the midsection, elbow to the midsection by Putski, and a rake of the eyes breaks the momentum. Back and forth, this match has gone. Dane delivers a roundhouse right. Reversal by Putski. Goes for the dive, but misses. Dane out of the way. Putski has taken quite a bit of punishment, courtesy of Stephen Dane. So Dane may have a little bit more of his wits about him here. Dane, uppercut. And Scott Putski is just looking for an opening, trying to get a second win, but every time he seems to be getting a second win, Stephen Dane breaks the eyes or throws an uppercut or puts in a shot like that. Whip into the corner, Dane follows in, but the boot is up. Nice move there. Roundhouse. Putski into the ropes. Clothesline. Heads down Dane. Dane wants a timeout. I don't think he's going to get one. Into the ropes. Cool slam by Putski. But only good for a count of two. Into the ropes they go. High backdrop. Down goes Dane. Dane staggers over to the corner. Putski follows him in, but Dane going to the boot. Puts it into his knee pad. That right knee pad loaded up now, and the fans know it. I don't know if Putski does, however. Into the corner. Putski follows in, and that knee delivered. Remember, that was the one with a foreign object in it. Misses with a knee lift. Dane missed with a knee lift, and now Putski back to the ropes. Polish hammer. Down goes Dane for a three count. Scott Putski with a win.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match is Scott Putski.